So Android devices usually take a really long time to get updated. This is because it's a really complicated process where the manufacturer of the processors have to update their firmware before the OEM, the phone manufacturers, can update the software for their phones. Now, it's a really long, complicated process, and generally this means that a lot of phone manufacturers just don't even update their phones after the first few updates. Now, Google's trying to change this, so when they introduced Android 8.0 Oreo, they also introduced Project Treble. What this does is it basically separates the SoC, the processor's work, from the OEM, the phone manufacturer's work. So now you have the processor's firmware, which gets updated independently of the rest of the software on the phone. You can update the software of the phone as many times as you want now without having to worry about the firmware that is for the processor. This means it's a lot faster for the OEMs to go in and to update their phones. So as an analogy, let's say you have two bins of marbles. You have a bin of marbles, just one bin of marbles, and it's mixed with red and blue marbles. And you want to update, or you want to not update, you want to just replace all your red marbles. Well, first you have to dump them all out. Then you have to sort out the blue ones and the red ones. Now, then once you put all the new red ones back in, you have to put them all back in the bin, and then they're mixed up again. And if you want to do this process over and over again, it takes a really long time to constantly sort through everything. Now, for example, with Project Treble, with the new update, it would be like having two bins of marbles with the red and the blue ones separately. Now, if you want to replace the red ones, now all you have to do is dump out the red bin, put the new red marbles in, and you're good to go. It takes a lot less time. There's no sorting. So in this analogy, basically you have the blue marbles, which are the SoC's firmware that just stays put, or it can be updated by itself. And then the red marbles would be the software developed by the phone companies. So basically, what does this mean for the user? It means that updates can come to your phone a lot faster because the phone companies have a lot less work to do when they update their phones. This doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to happen because, well, I mean, phone companies, they just want to sell the phone the first time. They don't really care too much about keeping it updated, but it means it is possible. Now, if you're a more advanced user, what this means is that ROMs can be updated and produced a lot more quickly. No longer do you have to wait for the software, for custom kernels and such to be made for each ROM. You can have one version of Android, one image, run on a whole bunch of different devices. Recently, phones such as the Essential Phone, the Huawei Honor 8 Pro, I believe, and the Huawei Mate 9, all of these ran the single stock Android because of Project Treble. Before, it was not possible for all of these phones to run the exact same image, and now it is. So, let's say you wanted to use CyanogenMod on one of these phones, Cyanogen only has to create one version of it instead of creating like 20 different versions for 20 different phones. They can create their one image, and then because of Project Treble, it will run on all of these phones that use Project Treble. And this is all great, and Google is going to be forcing manufacturers to use Project Treble in any phones coming out with Android 8.0, which is great. However, I suspect that this is going to be kind of a repeat of what we saw with Google and Android 6 when they began forcing encryption. After that, a lot of phones came out with 5.1.1 instead of 6 because they were trying to get around the requirement of encryption. So I suspect we'll see a lot of phones coming out with Android 7.0 for a while, but eventually, in order to stay competitive, these companies are going to have to do Android 8.0, which is great for the consumer, faster updates, more ROM support. So yeah, it's an exciting time for Android. All right, so that's all I had for today. We did this in one take. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.